have a 22-year-old son, and we just found you a few months ago.
There's still hope.
You, the way you teach, the way that you inspire, was bringing me over my level, over my limit. All of a sudden I'm getting these strange and new and wonderful abilities. And then my son recently got himself hooked on heroin.
Back down you mean? Why did you go back down? What happened?
Sorry.
Oh, that's quite all right.
I don't know how to help him. Mm-hmm. I'm trying.
So you feel powerless?
Well, we got him off of it once.
Sorry?
We got him off of it once. You know, he dried out the first time, and then he went back to it. And now I feel powerless and helpless and hopeless. Mm-hmm.
How could you realign your vision so that you actually feel powerful?
The only way that I have been thinking to do it is to save him, but I don't know how to do that without...
To save him from what?
Dying.
And then what? He'll be more free than you when he dies. I understand that's not your preference.
Well, no, yeah, that's. But it is true. it is true. It's just, thank you very much.
Do you understand that what serves one person might not always look pleasant in society's eyes?
What do you mean?
That the choices that he makes might actually be perfect for his journey. And that by taking away his catalyst, his pain, his suffering, his challenge, his struggle, his addiction, by taking that away for him against his free will, a few things will happen. A, you will postpone his eventual epiphany. You will make him use again, because he might stop at some point, but if it's not out of total free will, it's not permanent. You're giving off the vibe that something is wrong, not that everything's perfect.
Right.
You will emphasize that, and therefore you will continue to exacerbate his struggle, even though you don't want to.
Right.
And by exacerbating his struggle, he'll probably feel more addicted or grabbed for the things that he knows makes him feel different or good. In this case, potentially heroin.
Right. Wow.
So paradoxical as it sounds, in order to establish the effects you want to establish, you need to let go of your need and desire for that. And you need to actually see it differently. Now, this may take a little bit of time, maybe not, but this might take a little bit of tweaking of your own ways of seeing. And I know that that is hard from your present point of view, because it seems like a really extreme case. And I'm not necessarily saying that it's not, but on the global scale of things that are occurring, it's quite all right. It's quite average in certain ways.
Right.
It might just be heroin for him, but there's worse ways to be addicted even than that. In other words, try to gain as much perspective for yourself as you can. See it in the larger picture of both his journey, well, mostly in the larger picture of his journey. See that he is not alone. He is guided. The most profound way you can help him is by helping him understand his emotional guidance system. Does that make sense?
Yes.
That when he feels bad, it's because his perspective is out of alignment with however you want to communicate that to him, his soul, his overall perspective, his inner being's perspective, something that guides him.
Okay.
Point him to the fact, if you can, without infringing upon his free will, but out of respect and out of love, if you can somehow show him, most of all by example,
right,
secondarily by instruction and education, that he has a guidance system that's always with him. And that if he feels bad about something, that doesn't mean something is actually wrong. It means that his perspective about what is out of alignment. And that he always has the tools he needs, if he wants to, and that he can develop those, that there's tools out there, people live like this, that he can very quickly bump himself back into alignment and start to generate a very ecstatic, liberated life without the means of drugs, etc., so that he can actually find his balance, find his alignment, find his power within himself. Now, that's the only way you can help him, not by changing his journey, but by educating his journey, by enlightening his journey, by shedding as much brightness, light, love, unconditional love, and freedom, and tools, through example, onto his journey that you can, so that he has much more to choose from. You cannot choose for him, but you can offer him more to choose from. in order for you to be able to fully efficiently do that, you need to first change your perspective about his state being wrong and see it as the most beautiful thing that ever happened to him. And make no mistake, that is how his higher self sees it. Doesn't mean his higher self is not also coaxing him back into alignment in a more proficient way. It doesn't mean his higher self doesn't also desire for him to like learn the lessons as smoothly and beautifully and fast as he can so that he can be in alignment and recognize that power consciously and call on it all the time and develop a healthy, mutual, two-way communication with his inner being. Yes, that is also in his higher self's desire. But also, higher self or higher mind is still guiding his process. It is still preventing it from going too far out of alignment while still respecting his free will to make his choices and see things the way he wants to see it. But it's always there. It's always coaxing him. It's always guiding him. He's never alone. He's taken care of. He has a higher self. He has a journey. And this is a part of it at this timing. Can you embrace that?
I can.
Awesome. That's beautiful. That's a great act of love. And whenever we act on unconditional love, every part of us gets activated and amplified and redoubled in that sense. So every skill you already have, the brightness you already have, the availability, the skillfulness you already have in you to offer him, not to force feed him, to offer him, will be amplified by your act of transcending yourself and becoming a shepherding consciousness, which sees lower life in alignment from the higher perspective. Means there is no judgment.
Okay.
Which means there's understanding of the way things are going, being held in a greater perspective. If you can align first with that greater perspective, all your inherent and innate powers will come out powerfully. You'll feel on top of yourself again. You'll feel powerful again. You'll feel activated again. And as a result of that, you will fully be able to be available and help and shine a light. And when it becomes too attached again, all that means is that your perspective is starting to narrow down again and be too physically focused and perceive lack. From the physical point of view, it's very impossible to not perceive any lack. From the non-physical point of view, it's impossible to perceive a lot of lack, if at all.
Right.
So you have to be in the lackless view of the non-physical greater understanding of these journeys happening perfectly so that now you can bring this brightness, unconditional love and resonance with you in your frequency, subliminally and verbally, when requested or when appropriate to your son's condition. Mm. Does that make sense?
Absolutely.
Can you do that?
I can.
Can you let yourself off the hook with the scenario? It's not your life. It's not your scenario. No matter what he chooses, no matter how much you love him, this does not have to be your burden. It's not meant to be your burden. It's meant to be your challenge. It's meant to be your challenge to grow into a bigger you,
okay,
into a more understanding you, into a more powerful balance between love and wisdom you. But it's not meant to be your burden. It's not meant to be your life. He is an independent being, no matter where he came from physically.
Right.
He is like a neighbor. He is like a friend for whom you want what's best, obviously. But the only way you can offer that is by offering it, not by forcing it, not by trying to change or take away certain issues, because these issues are precisely what he's attracting to himself to be able to reflect upon himself. Take away the issues and he'll go down even deeper to attract issues that are even more obvious.
Wow.
Does that make sense?
Yes.
We have to accept that the ones that we love will choose to suffer from time to time. If we can't, we're fuck-ups. And we cannot be of service. We have to accept that this is part of the way that souls create their journey sometimes. No matter how much you love them, if you really, really love them, you would not want to take away all of their problems because they will not learn what they want to learn. They will not expand in the ways that they want to expand. You can always offer light. You can always offer love. You can always offer unconditional clarity. You can always offer what works for you. But you can only teach by inspiration, secondarily by verbalization, but only when appropriate or asked for. Does that make sense?
Yes, it does.
Does it feel more powerful?
It does.
Do you feel like you can actually do something in that way and be more of yourself and be powerful? Because that's important.
I feel like I can breathe again, yes.
Breathe again. Beautiful. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.